Our next speaker will be Jeff Alexander. He is Richard Carl Jelinek Professor of Health Management and Policy at the School of Public Health at the University of Michigan and holds positions in the university's Ross School of Business and Institute for Social Research. His teaching and research interests focus on organizational change in the healthcare sector, multi-institutional systems, governance, and physician participation in institutional management and policymaking. Dr. Alexander, please take the podium.
Thank you, Steve. This was really an interesting paper to write in several respects. But so if you look at the notion of time, you know, on the surface, it seems like a fairly circumscribed and fairly narrowly fairly narrow in its coverage. But in fact, as we try to illustrate in the paper, it has broad implications for how multi-level interventions are conceptualized, how program designs may be structured or designed, how research on multi-level interventions is done, and even how statistical analyses and measurement is performed. So fairly circumscribed concept with broad implications. I guess the subcontext for this slide would be things change. And I think that's what the paper is essentially about. I don't care what level you're talking about, whether it's the individual level, the organizational level, or the environmental level, things do not remain in a steady state. And the paper really addresses how these changes over time might affect the impact of a multi-level intervention at multiple levels, and particularly at the individual level. In some respects, time might be viewed as the third dimension. Sounds like the Twilight Zone, but the third dimension of a multi-level intervention. The first two being what happens at each level. The second being what happens between levels or cross levels, and then the third dimension being time itself. So if we look at the vertical relationships in MLIs and how they are affected differently by change, we can come up with a couple of illustrative of examples. So for example, a particular MLI might have differential effects on individuals depending on where that individual was in their disease life course or where they were starting in the intervention. So a takeaway here is that time can help us think about when an intervention might be more or less effective, how it should be designed to target particular populations or subpopulations. And the same thing goes if you're looking at higher levels, if you're looking at the organizational or environmental level. So, for example, very few interventions, I think, occur outside a specific social context. These social contexts have a way of changing over time. So, for example, at the organizational level, you might argue that depending on changes in organizational priorities, resources, availability of technical support, et cetera, or simply entropy, the interventions and their effects on individual patient outcomes might differ through nothing to do with the intervention itself, but the social context under which the intervention operates. So in my simple way of thinking about this, and this is for those of you who are more kind of visually oriented, this is my schematic of maybe a typical MLI. You have three levels: environment, organization, and individual. And then the second dimension illustrated here is obviously the relationship between and across levels. And when you add time, things get complicated in a hurry. Because in the paper, as I argue, particularly the cross-level effects tend to take on a different shape and different meaning than if you were just to look at an MLI in a cross-sectional fashion. And I'm kind of telegraphing my big question at the end. But the takeaway here in this slide is that, particularly looking at the cross-level effects, I would submit that they will be very different than if you were just to look at this in a static way. So where does time fit in multi-level intervention, both in terms of evaluation and program design? I think it's important for us to think about how time affects patients, and time is often viewed as a level, if you will, or a dimension that's embedded within individual patients. As the example I gave previously suggests, it could operate at the organization level as priorities change in the organization. The development of that organization and the intervention itself might be affected, and at the environmental level, similar changes could occur. Importantly, again, what's problematic to me is how these changes that occur over time affect the cross-level nature of the relationship between the intervention and the targets of those interventions. And the way we approached this in the paper was by dealing with four distinct topics. The first being the role of disease life course and growth trajectories in multi-level interventions. The second being a discussion of approaches to incorporating time and research and program design for multi-level interventions. The third being analysis of time using multi-level data. Here we talk about specific analytic techniques. And finally, and this is sort of a word of caution, the resource considerations that have to be taken into consideration if you're to expand from thinking about MLIs in two-dimensional fashion to a three-dimensional fashion. And my big question, I only have one, but it is a big one, and what I would like to hear from the various groups is something I've been struggling with, is if you shift your thinking to three dimensions, that is, if you incorporate time in your thinking about multi-level intervention, how does that affect the way you think about how different levels affect processes or outcomes at other levels? And I think this is important not only for conceptual reasons, but also for practical reasons. So we were discussing at the table this morning how MLI research is going to be considerably more expensive in all probability than the research we're used to. And we really do need to think carefully and clearly about the theoretical underpinnings of the relationship across dimensions. And again, I think time only adds to that complexity. So I'll stop there, and I look forward to talking about this in the small groups.
Thank you, Jeff. Uh-huh.